everyone, my name is Tasha and welcome to Enterprise Risk Management Academy. Now, let's talk about the first main component of ISO 31000, the risk management principles. Risk management principles are the basis for managing risk. It's like the backbone of a human body. Naturally, we want to identify what will go wrong inside our organization and at the same time identify opportunities by improving our management system. Let's look at this diagram. We can see where the principles are based on value creation and protection, which is the purpose of risk management. This purpose is not a single factor, but it's surrounded by the 8 risk management principles. So let's dive into it one by one. The first one, integrated. Risk management shouldn't be considered extra work for you to complete after doing so many other things. We want risk management to be a regular part of our everyday jobs. But most importantly, risk management has to be an integral part of all organizational activities. We must break the existing silos in applying the ERM. The second one, structured and comprehensive. A structured and comprehensive approach to risk management contributes to consistent and comparable results. This component emphasizes that risk management should be implemented systematically in our organization by developing a framework design that serves as a roadmap for coordinated risk management implementation. The third one, customized. It's pretty self-explanatory, isn't it? Risk management must be customized to meet the needs of your organization in particular, not others. Risk management has to be enterprise specific. For example, organization A in the telecommunication industry would have a different set of risks if you compare it with organization B in the insurance industry. However, organization A would also face different kinds of risk compared to organization C, though it moves around the same industry. Every organization has their own reflection on the definition of objectives, so the risk won't be the same. Number 4, inclusive. Be sure to include everyone who will be directly involved on the job, as well as those who will be providing direction and planning. The main idea of the principle is to involve the relevant stakeholders in managing your risk. There will be a time that you might need a few from a wide array of expertise, for instance, because there's no master of all, right? So, an appropriate and timely involvement of these stakeholders will enable their knowledge, views, and perceptions to be taken into account. As a result, you'll have a more comprehensive understanding of risk, and as it may also improve awareness and inform risk management, you will be able to develop a more effective strategy overall and take better decisions. Number 5, dynamic. It's kind of sad to see some organizations develop a really great risk management framework, but they put it on the shelf and wait to see if they did a good job. Risk could arise, change, or even disappear anytime as an organization context changes. In this manner, risk management should anticipate, detect, recognize, and respond to changes and events in an appropriate and timely manner. Simply put, dynamic risk management will require your organization to be sensitive to changes that have and may occur, especially those that could undermine the effectiveness of organizational risk management. Number 6, best available information. The point of this principle is that a lack of information could put a decision-making off or even leads to a wrong decision. Risk management doesn't need the best possible information, instead, it requires to use the best available information. In the ideal world, 100% information would be beneficial to make a right decision. But in reality, the best possible information takes a very long time. It's very much time-consuming, right? And it's rather impossible, to be honest. It will be taking too long just to search for the perfect information, and eventually, the decisions are no longer relevant because the right timing and the momentum has gone away. So be sure to give your best effort and collecting the best available information to make your decision. Number 7, human and cultural factors. Risk management is a competence embedded at an individual basis. Its implementation depends greatly on the person carrying it out, as well as the risk attitude of each individual, including the role of risk leadership. That said, this means human behavior and culture have a significant impact on all aspects of risk management at all levels and stages. In fact, it always starts and comes back to people. Number 8, continual improvement. This is the last one, I promise. Just like the old saying, even Homer sometimes nods. Do a regular analysis and evaluation of the existing systems, and practice continual development towards them. This allows your risk management system to become stronger and more effective from time to time. And on top of that, it will also keep it up to date, and it's one of the ways to ensure your organization is resilient. Okay, we have come to the end of our video, and this is a quick overview of the principles of risk management based on ISO 31000. By embedding these 8 principles, our organization could create and protect value. Thanks for watching, and we hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more educational content like this only in Enterprise Risk Management Academy. Bye!